So recently, I did a video on my Razer Blade 14, which is a laptop that I have owned for the last 5 years, and it's still growing really strong. And I was just kind of in the mood to make a video on some of my older tech that I still use in 2020 per se, since 2020 did just start very recently. And one of those pieces of tech is going to be this guy right here. So this is my Samsung Galaxy Tab S3. This tablet isn't really nearly as old as my Razer Blade 14. This is still a bit dated and retrospective, as now we have the Tab S4 and the Tab S6, as the Tab S5 does not exist, by the way. So with two more generations ahead of this one, is this still a viable tablet at all? Is it still good? Should I be upgrading it anytime soon? And I've asked myself these questions many times, and the answer has still been no every time. Because as of now, in my opinion, there just isn't much of a reason to really upgrade from the Tab S3. There's plenty to upgrade from the Tab S2, but if you have the Tab S3, maybe you shouldn't be upgrading anytime soon unless the features that the other ones are offering are absolutely vital. But right now, the Tab S3 fulfills my purposes just fine, and let me walk you through my journey, my experiences with the Tab S3. Let's dive in. This video is sponsored by Feefine, the makers of some of the best audio gear on a great budget, like the ones from their C1 models featuring a professional-grade lavalier mic and the headset mics bundled together. Links to everything below. So reason number one is going to be its beautiful design. I believe that aesthetically, the Tab S3 is still absolutely beautiful. It still looks incredibly sleek, and it's made of glass on the back and glass on the front, and the cornerings over here, or the trimmings, are going to be constructed of this very strong aluminum that feels incredibly smooth and incredibly sturdy. In terms of its design, you're also going to get just a very thin tablet, and it's going to be incredibly strong, and overall, the Tab S3, even to this day, still feels incredibly premium. So when it comes to its design, I really can't complain here, if much at all. And you got a couple other things, like the quad speaker setup, which you're going to find two speakers on one side and then two other speakers on another, and they combine to give you a pretty decent audio. And you're going to be getting a USB-C port, a headphone jack, which is always welcome. And I still hate that this jack is gone at all, as this was always a really convenient thing to have around, and you don't really start missing it until you don't have it anymore, which is unfortunate, and that was the case with me. And you still get a micro SD card slot as well, which is always very helpful. And you still get your hardware buttons, which are always nice to have, and especially fingerprint scanner, which you just won't get on something like the Tab S4, for example, which is quite unfortunate. So this tablet is definitely pretty future-packed. You're going to be finding also a couple of pins around the bottom, which are going to be very useful for connecting it to the keyboard attachment, which is always really nice to have. I really love this tablet, and it just offers a lot of the really cool features that a lot of the newer tablets have, and it still looks fantastic. I love it. And number two is going to be the incredible screen that the Galaxy Tab S3 still has to this day. It still gets incredibly bright, and the colors are super nice and very saturated as well, even though they're not too overdone, I would say. It's one of the things that I personally like the most about it. You'll be getting yourself a 9.7-inch screen, and it's an OLED screen, so in my opinion, it's gonna be a little bit better than IPS, even though it may not be the case for something like color accurate work, and it's just a little bit better for things like content consumption and gaming and that sort of thing, which, by the way, this tablet still does really well. Just watching videos, especially when you combine it with a quad speaker setup, you've got yourself a pretty decent entertainment system, even though most of that quality is admittedly coming from the screen itself. Watching content, even just drawing on it, it just feels really good and it looks really nice. The colors are super vibrant, and this is just everything I would want out of a screen around this size. In terms of the resolution, you got yourself a resolution that's just a little bit below 1440p and a little bit higher than 1080p. Both of these are actually relatively sharp, especially at the screen size, so seeing that you still got very sharp display here at this size, it's still a very nice breath of fresh air. The only thing that's really just a little bit different than what you will find on a lot of different devices, and especially on newer iterations of the Tab S6 and the Tab S4, for example, it's just that the Tab S3 is not going to have a 16:9 screen, which means that if you're watching content or anything like that, you're going to see a little bit of letterboxing around the top and the bottom of the screens, which doesn't really bother me all that much, especially since in return for that, so much better. And that is just going to be a greater efficiency when it comes to productivity and just multitasking. If I want to multitask by splitting the screen into two, It's just more comfortable since the aspect ratio is a little bit more squared and not so wide, and it just makes it a lot better for fitting a lot of text onto one side of the screen, and it just makes it a lot nicer. Being productive on the Tab S3, I would say, is a little bit better and more efficient than it would be on newer iterations of this tablet. So I gotta give it that. I really love the display on the Galaxy Tab S3. And number three is just going to be for the mostly reliable performance here. I'll elaborate. So for the times, the Tab S3 actually had pretty beefy specs at around the time it was released, at least. And even today, the specs might still lag behind a little bit. And when it comes to the majority of applications, and in particular applications that have to do with productivity, for example, you do still get pretty decent performance, and it's still relatively smooth, even if you want to do a little bit of multitasking. However, when it comes to things like sometimes just loading into certain applications, it might just start to lag a little bit. And that's the type of lag that I didn't really experience around the time that I had purchased the Tab S3. So I do find this to be a little bit strange, and it just leads me directly into talking about the battery life, which has also degraded a little bit. Not too much, but definitely a noticeable change here. I used to get around 8 hours of screen on time, and that's been reduced to around 5 hours of screen time. I never have to use this tablet for that amount of time and just one sitting anyway, so it never really dies on me on just one session, but sometimes I'll just put it to bed and sometime later it'll end up being dead or the battery will just be extremely low. So yeah, that's another thing to keep into consideration when it comes to the Tab S3 so far. So not everything about this tablet has been peaches and cream exactly. However, I have been having a pretty decent experience with it, and I still don't see myself upgrading anytime soon. But it's a good thing that I bring up a little bit of the bad and some of the things that I have experienced over time, other than the things I just mentioned, being the battery life and slightly not so reliable performance, even though it doesn't come up all of the time. Cameras have not aged very well at all, actually. I didn't used to be that great at the time. However, now they just look incredibly dated. And that goes for the rear-facing camera and the front-facing camera, so that is unfortunate. The Tab S3's keyboard case, unfortunately, does not come with a trackpad to it, which is a little bit disappointing. Would have really liked that at the time. However, the frustrations of not having a trackpad do start to show with the more you have it. And newer ones do have that feature, and I just wish that the Tab S3 would have also had that to begin with. So it's just a slight annoyance there, really. It's not a huge deal, it's just kind of annoying per se. And the stylus itself too is a little bit uncomfortable. It's just a little bit too thin, and it's just got a little bit of an uncomfortable shape to it. I like the texture, it's a soft touch material, and it can be fairly comfortable. However, you just have to get yourself adjusted to it. And if you're going to be using it for long periods of time, then you might start to get a little bit cramped with it, and that's just kind of unfortunate. Another frustration is that Adobe Premiere Rush is not supported with the Galaxy Tab S3, which is another huge annoyance for me. I edit videos on the go of this sort of machine, which is something that I was really excited with. So unfortunately, I have to call it quits there. But in conclusion, the Tab S3 has still been a really great device here, even though I haven't had the most amazing time with it that I thought I was going to have in the long run. When I first got it, I was really mesmerized with it. I would carry this around everywhere with me, considering just how lightweight, how beautiful, and how efficient, and just how productive I could get with this tablet, and I still can. It's just that I've been starting to miss a couple of things that I wish that this tablet had, and I never did. And the newer models do have it, however, you still end up losing on a couple of things with those newer models that you get with the old one, like a headphone jack, for example, and a fingerprint scanner, and that sort of thing, and the aspect ratio, with the screen just being ideal for productivity. But with that said, I will be upgrading in due time. However, not yet. Not to the Tab S4, and not to the Tab S6. As tempting as it might be at times, I just don't have enough of a reason to upgrade that admittedly lose out on some of the features that I care about, especially when it comes to a device that is this size. I like to wait and see what the Tab S7 has in store for me, even what the Tab S8 has. But for now, the Tab S3 is still a champion in my eyes, and if you can find yourself one of these, and as long as it's getting updates for the next couple of years or something like that, then hey, it might still be worth a look in 2020, if I'm honest. And if you're interested in purchasing the Tab S3, then I will be making sure to leave affiliate links to Amazon in the description. And if you decide to use any of my links and make a purchase, then I do end up getting a small commission that does help me run things a little more smoothly around here. So if you were to use those, I would appreciate that quite a bit. This has been Francisco from Tech Summit. Thank you for watching, and I'll be seeing you all later. Enjoy.